Hey guys, Adam Lobo here from Adam Lobo TV. So, we all know there are lots of differences in terms of the hardware and especially on the software for these two phones. And of course, the cameras on these two phones are still one of the industry leading, especially when it comes to the overall camera specs from a hardware perspective as well and image processing. So in this video, we'll take a look on how the Samsung Galaxy S21 Ultra's camera is compared to another camera king, which is the Huawei Mate 40 Pro. First, let's look at the camera specs. Now, the Samsung Galaxy S21 Ultra comes with a 108-megapixel f1.8 24mm wide lens, a 10-megapixel f4.9 240mm periscope telephoto lens with 10x optical zoom, a 10-megapixel f2.4 70mm telephoto lens, and a 12-megapixel f2.2 13mm ultra-wide angle lens, where the camera arrays also have the dedicated laser autofocus, which is also available at the back as well. Then looking at the Huawei Mate 40 Pro, it comes with a 50-megapixel f1.9 aperture, 23mm wide lens, a 12-megapixel f3.4, 125mm periscope telephoto lens with 5x optical zoom, and a 20-megapixel f1.8, 18mm ultra-wide-angle lens. Now please keep in mind that the exact color and details may vary as this could be due to the YouTube's compression, but just so you all know that I've used the Asus ZenBook Flip S 4K OLED laptop, which I'll be reviewing really soon, as the laptop has 100% DCI P3 color gamut color accurate screen. So without further ado, let's get started. Now looking at the high megapixel mode, as expected since the S21 Ultra has a higher 100 megapixel as opposed to a 50 megapixel on the Mate 40 Pro, you'll get more details if you zoom and crop in post. But without zooming, both of them looked and performed very similar. So this does come down to how often you need to zoom in and crop into your images to know which devices are better in this category. Now, I did mention that I've always loved the focal length of Samsung devices, as the S21 Ultra is wider at 13mm instead of 18mm on the Mate 40 Pro, because as a content creator, I can tell you that an 18mm lens is not really considered as an ultra wide angle lens as opposed to a 13mm. So thus, as seen in these images, you'll get more focal length on the S21 Ultra. Now the colors on the buildings towards the top are more color accurate on the S21 Ultra, where the pictures on the Mate 40 Pro had a slight blue tint in the images. Now looking at the main lens, similar like the ultra wide angle lens, the pictures on the Mate 40 Pro had a blue tint on the images. Yes, you can adjust this in post, but please keep in mind that the S21 Ultra seems to produce a more color accurate photos. And once again, the same can be said when it comes to the 10x zoom images as well. And speaking of zoom images, the S21 Ultra can go up to 100x zoom and the Mate 40 Pro can go up to 50x zoom. And comparing on the 50x zoom, since Samsung has introduced the zoom lock feature to lock into the image to make the subject be less shaky, as seen on the Mate 40 Pro footage over here, you'll get better results on the S21 Ultra even if you wanna go up to 100x zoom. Now, there's no dedicated macro cameras on both phones, which, bravo, thank you so much for not having a lens for the sake of having a lens. Now, the good news is that the ultra-wide lens converts into a macro mode when going close into a subject, where the color accuracy and the details on the fabric is more pronounced on the S21 Ultra. So, I've tested the rear portrait mode both on humans, which is me, and on subjects as well, where Samsung had a better subject to background blur, which can be adjusted after taking a shot, which is still very nice to know. And the colors on the skin tone seems to be a bit more saturated, and the details can be soft, as seen at my t-shirt and my mask area, where there are more details on the Mate 40 Pro. So yes, I have to give this to the Mate 40 Pro. Now, as for taking photos of objects, the background blur was the same. The only difference is that the blacks are darker on the Mate 40 Pro or the shadows. So this does come down to a personal preference. Now, as for the night mode, focal length aside, The good news is that the Mate 40 Pro is brighter on the overall images, as Huawei is very well known for their low light capabilities for years and years. But yet again, the skies this time around had a blue tint, which we all know how dark sky looks like. It's black, not blue. So I'm not sure what Huawei is doing over here. And if you really want a pixel peep, I've noticed there is some chromatic aberration towards these shadows as well. Now the colors for the non-sky images were better in terms of the color accuracy once again on the S21 Ultra, as seen on the tile floorings of these shots. Now while both phones has night mode for the selfie shots, I personally don't favor any one of it. But if I had to force to make a choice, I would go with the S21 Ultra because of the extreme exposure emits from the Huawei Mate 40 Pro screen, where it had a bright light when you put on to the night mode, which is quite weird when it comes to the overall exposure when taking selfie night mode shots. And again, it is the same blue tint as seen on my t-shirt, because my t-shirt was black, or is black, and not blue as seen on the Mate 40 Pro. Now you can zoom in accordingly, but the images were not very usable beyond 10x zoom. But the S21 Ultra retains the highlights better as seen on this building's logo. Now I also took pictures of my pet leopard gecko Joaquin in a super low light situation in an almost complete darkness, as the boy is nocturnal. And while both images were bright, which was good news, yet again we see better details on the S21 Ultra. Now looking at the selfie camera specs, on the S21 Ultra, it comes with a 40 megapixel f2.2 26mm wide lens, and the Mate 40 Pro comes with a 13 megapixel f2.4 18mm ultra wide angle lens. Now there is a high megapixel mode on the Samsung Galaxy S21 Ultra, but I thought it was unfair to compare that. And just so y'all know that both of the beauty mode on the selfie cameras were turned off, so keep that in mind when it comes to the results. Now onto the regular selfies, the dynamic range on both phones were equally as good. However, Samsung has way much details on the skin. You can see that the images are looking a bit softer as seen on the forehead area, and the colors of the t-shirt is also more close to real life as well. Now Samsung has better subject to background blur on the edge detection, and details are also clear on the portrait selfie mode on the subject. For this case is my face, of course. Now when it comes to taking selfies in a very highlighted background situation or a backlit situation, while the background is properly detailed on both images, but yet again, the S21 Ultra gets better details on the skin compared to what you see on the Mate 40 Pro. Now, before I go into the final video comparison, if you guys are enjoying this video, be sure to give this video a nice big thumbs up and subscribe to Adam Lobo TV. That would be very much appreciated. And finally, looking at the video taking capabilities, the S21 Ultra can record up to 8K resolution, where the Mate 40 Pro can't. So I just tested the comparison on the 4K video recording. Now, quality and dynamic range was very similar with slightly different colors between the both. So this does come down again to a personal preference. Image stabilization is better on the ultra wide angle lens on the S21 Ultra, but was very similar on the main lens on both phones. Now as for the front video selfie, both records up to 4K resolution, and while the image stabilization was really gimbal-like, if the light is towards you, that means in front of you, both of the video footage had great quality. But where the Mate 40 Pro suffers once again is when there is backlight present, where it overcompensates on the whole image, including the subject, where you can see my skin were overexposed. Alright guys, that's my comparison between these two phones. And with this, do let me know which you think is a better camera at the comment section below, and let's chat over there.